ഹലോ എവ്രി വൺ, ടുഡേ വി ആർ ഹിയർ വിത്ത് ദ റിയൽ ഹീറോ ഓഫ് ദി മൂവി. ഹീറോ ഇപ്പം ഇറങ്ങിയിരിക്കുന്ന ഒരു പുതിയ മുഖം ആണ് ഇത്. എന്തായാലും ലെറ്റ്സ് ആസ്ക് ഹിം മോർ അബൌട്ട് ദിസ് മൂവി, ബിക്കോസ് ഹീസ് വർക്ക്ഡ് എ ലോട്ട് എന്ന് കാണാം. ലോട്ട് ഓഫ് ഹോം വർക്ക്, റൈറ്റ്? യു മസ്റ്റ് ഹാവ് സ്റ്റാർട്ടഡ് പ്രിപ്പയറിംഗ് ഫോർ ദിസ് മൂവി എ ലോങ് ടൈം.
ഐ ഡോണ്ട് നോ ഇഫ് ദേർ വാസ് എ ലോട്ട് ഓഫ് ഹോം വർക്ക്, ബട്ട് വാട്ട് ഹാപ്പൻഡ് വാസ് ഓർ വാട്ട് പീപ്പിൾ പെർസീവ് ടു ബി ഇസ് എ ഹാർഡ് വർക്ക് ഇസ് ദാറ്റ് ദേർസ് ബീൻ a physical transformation that I have had to go through, but I should not be lying in saying that that's exclusively for this film. I was also shooting my Hindi film simultaneously, so both these films required me to look a certain way, and in our initial rounds of discussion for Hero, we decided that the physicality of this character had to come through.
Okay.
So Deepan, the director,
let us clear the doubt. They might want to know what exactly you're playing, because Korebir Kariyathila, he's playing the role of a stunt master, right?
Not stunt master, I play the role of a stunt artist. I assist a stunt master in the film.
Yeah.
So I play this guy called Anthony, who is called in to be the dupe, you know, for heroes when they have to do shots that involve risk.
Okay.
And there are people there in cinema, you know, even I've had people take over shots from me when there's actual danger involved.
Okay.
So
I'll take a salary will be very high, like,
you know, nothing is high enough.
So obviously they're risking their life.
Yeah.
For you.
Yeah, because none of these shots that they execute have anything called a 100% guarantee scenario.
Safety, yeah.
Yeah, so there's always an if, and I know people who have lost their lives, and I've had people who have worked with me who have lost their lives, fortunately not in my films. But yeah, it's a very, very unpredictable, and even more importantly, it's the least glamorous field of cinema. You will never have seen titles that mention the fight,
yes,
artists in a film, or you would never have seen a title card that says dupes and then names, you know. They are never mentioned, they are never talked about, and the irony of the whole thing is that even if there is a dupe shot in a film, the whole effort and endeavor is to keep that hidden.
Yeah, like, so nobody should know about it.
Yeah, so in a way it's the least glamorous field of cinema.
So I guess this movie can be dedicated to all the people who lost their lives and still
it is a homage to all the stunt artists and dupe artists who are and have been involved with cinema over the years, and that though is just you know, all just a background of the film.
Okay.
The film is the story is about this underdog's road to victory, journey to victory, and it's about love and it's about revenge and it's about success, and you know, although it's packaged like that, the fact that it's said in this background, I believe,
okay,
makes it a little fresh.
So let's now ask him about the shots that he did, like risky atle definitely you must have done. So any wild atle karyangal cheyathu?
ലോട്ട് ഓഫ് തിങ്സ് ആക്ച്വലി ഇൻ ദിസ് ഫിലിം. നമ്മൾ ആദ്യമായിട്ട് ഈ സിനിമയുടെ ഒരു ഒരു തിരക്കഥയിലെ ഡിസ്കഷൻ ഇരുന്നപ്പോൾ വി ഡിസൈഡഡ് ദാറ്റ് സിൻസ് ഐ പ്ലേ എ ഡ്യൂപ്പ് ഇൻ ദ ഫിലിം ദാറ്റ് ഐ വിൽ നോട്ട് ഹാവ് എനി ഡ്യൂപ്സ് ഇൻ ദ ഫിലിം, ആൻഡ് ഓൾസോ ഇറ്റ് വാസ് റിക്വയർഡ് ഫോർ ദ സ്ക്രിപ്റ്റ് ബിക്കോസ് അൺലെസ് ദി ഓഡിയൻസ് സീസ് ദിസ് ഗൈഡ് ഡു ദിസ് യു നോ സീസ് മീ ഡൂയിങ് ഇറ്റ് ഐ ഡോണ്ട് തിങ്ക് ദിൽ ബി എബിൾ ടു റിലേറ്റ് ടു ദ ഫാക്ട് ദാറ്റ് ഇസ് വാട്ട് ഹി ഡസ് ഫോർ എ ലിവിംഗ്. സോ ഇൻ ഹീറോ ഐ ഹാവ് ടു കാറ്റഗോറിക്കലി സ്റ്റേറ്റ് ദാറ്റ് ദർ ഇസ് നോട്ട് എ സിംഗിൾ ഡ്യൂപ്പ് ഷോട്ട്. Everything that you see is actually done by the actors, and I don't mean just me, even Yami the heroine, even Srikant,
she has also done one.
She had to do this this scene where she had to jump from the 9th or 10th floor of a building, and she did that herself, you know. And even Srikant had a shot where he had to jump and break through glass and all that, which I know that in other films usually dupes do that, the actors don't do it themselves, but in this film we, you know, made it a point that with all the available possible safety equipments in place that the actors
are. And is it obvious that you guys are doing it? Ningal anna cheyyanannu.
Well, I hope it is.
Mogokku varunnundalle correct.
Yeah, yeah.
Chala dupe shot la bayangaraitu vigakku vechittu mogokku marayunna pole irikkum.
Idil anganum illa. Usually what you do when it's a dupe who's doing the shot is,
yeah,
either the camera is, the angle is composed such that it's against the light, so it's a silhouette, you know. But in this film we've had the liberty of actually shooting it the way it should be shot, because it's the actor who's doing it.
Yeah.
So everything from a bike jump to jumping off a building to jumping through fire and jumping over a moving car,
mm-hmm,
I've done it all in this film.
Okay, so now let's talk about the heroine.
Hmm.
I saw her movie Vicky Donnerler. She's done an excellent job.
Yeah.
So what do you have to say about her?
See, I met Yami a year and a half ago when I shot my first ad for Kalyan Silks.
Okay.
So Yami was the model who acted with me in that ad. Mm-hmm. And even then I noticed that, you know, she was beyond being just a model. So I spoke to her even then about whether she wanted to do cinema, and she said yes, she does, and she was listening to scripts. And later on when we decided that for Hero we needed a fresh face, Yami's name came to my mind and I spoke to her, and she listened to the script and she loved what the film was about and agreed to be part of it. Now that Vicky Donna has happened, now she's a big name in Bollywood and she deserves all the success because she's a very talented, very committed, very professional actress. Mm-hmm. And I think that girl has got a long way to go.
Yeah. So what do you have to say to the audience about the movie? Why should they watch this movie?
It's a fun film at the end, that's the bottom line, that it's a fun film.
It's a fun film, not action.
It's not action fun?
Okay.
So yeah, in that sense it's a it's an action packed fun film.
Obviously he's a very funny person.
What happened was, if you can see my shoes, yeah.
Actually it's a very cool thing. I noticed it, but it's a really good thing.
No, what happened was, you know, one day I've been shooting promotional programs one after the other. So morning I was dressed in a white shirt and blue jeans, and the red shoes looked pretty cool with that. So after a point in time, you know, I had to change the white shirt because I couldn't be seen in the same outfit in every channel. So I changed the shirt, but I don't have a spare shoe right now. So that's why.
But you need to understand one thing, Prithvi. Whatever stars are there, are a lot of young crowd over there, especially the males.
Okay.
They look up to people like you guys, and that's how the trends begin, right?
Okay, but so trust me. But trust me, green shirt and denims and red shoes are not. Advisable.
Cool. So I vote for it, and he's saying no to it. Anyway, no. He's wearing it. So.
Yeah, that I am. But.
So let's talk about the other. You're working with this director, Deepan, for the second time.
That's right. Yeah.
And your first, his first movie was Pudhiya Mugam with you.
Yeah.
And how is the chemistry between you both?
Well, obviously the comfort levels are very high, and the fact that we have known each other for so long means that we can work without a hierarchy in place. And that's not just between me and Deepan. Mm-hmm. Usually when we do a film, everybody on sets are, you know, have the freedom to come and make creative suggestions, and everybody is invited to watch the spot edit. And you know, as far as Hero is concerned, I've had production boys who have worked in the film call me up and say, Cheta, part in the matte shot, Matthew. They're all so tuned in to how the film was made. So in that sense, it is a completely organic team effort.
Everyone's,
you know,
involved in.
Yeah, so it's great to make films that way, because at the end of the day, it's a team sport.
Yes.
So and the fact that me and Deepan know each other for so long and so well, I think makes it easier for us and also people who work with us to be part of this whole work environment that we try and create.
Yeah, it's really good. So, what did your wife say about your new physique? Obviously, bhaaryamarkku ishtamulla bhartakkanmaaru nalla muscle okke ulla aalkaaraanu.
Well, she's not very keen on me spending 4 hours in the gym every day. So
why didn't you take her with you?
No, she does. She does come. She comes and works out with
four
me.
4 hours you work out every day?
At least 3 to 4. Yeah, I mean, I split my workouts into morning and evening sessions. So it's supposed to be 90 minutes each, but more often than not, it spills over. So it's for the last 6-7 months, it's been pretty tough. But now I'm just sitting back and relaxing because
So are you saying for the last 6 months, almost every day you've been hitting the gym like for 6 hours?
No, I don't mean that for the last 6 months, almost every day I've been hitting the gym. I mean that for the last 6 months, every day I have been hitting the gym.
He said the same thing again.
No, there's no almost there. So
anyone who is a lot of work, right?
Yeah, it's a lot
and
of work.
And you have to cut down on your food. Yeah, but where are diet again now?
Yeah, strangely, it was not about cutting down. It was, for me, about eating more. But obviously eating the right stuff.
Food lover.
I am. I'm a food lover, but unfortunately, like most food lovers, I love all the wrong stuff.
Yeah.
So it was about eating the right stuff and eating a lot of food in regular spaced intervals. And I had my trainer and my nutritionist who took care of my regimen and my chart. So yeah, it was a slow process.
To them mainly.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, they also had to put in a lot of work because, you know, for someone to undergo a change like that in 6 months, needs a lot of intense training.
Talking more about the movie, let's talk about the sets, because isn't the sets would have been different from the other movies, right?
I don't know. I mean,
the explosion.
Yeah, I mean, there is a lot of pyrotechnics involved, but the fact how the set was different was almost throughout the shoot, there was our action team and the safety team involved. And I don't mean just for the action sequences, because even in scenes in the film, there are shots that involve, people from the action department. Like, a lot of scenes require me to be, there's a scene where it's not a fight or an action sequence, but the scene is about me jumping off a cliff.
Okay.
So although it's just a scene, we will still need to have all the safety equipment in place, all the action paraphernalia in place. So in that sense, it was like, I don't think there was any other set that I've been part of where there was so much action and safety paraphernalia on sets every day of shoot.
Okay, is there any particular thing that happened during the shoot which you would like to share? Namal korchu bayangara over risk okke eduthu cheyidaru.
In the second half of the film, there's a song in which you will only fleetingly see a shot of me jumping over a moving car. So what happened was, in the shot was first set up, the stunt coordinator asked one of his fighters, one of his Antonys, to show me how it's done. And when he attempted the shot, he fell right in the front glass of the car and broke through and had to be taken to the hospital. So then everybody said, okay, it's cancelled, let's not do it, it's cancelled. But I was pretty adamant and stubborn and stupid that day. And I said, no, we have to, you know, just because this happened, we can't not let the shot
and
happen.
And you saw that happening,
right? Yeah, it happened in front of me.
And so, you knew where he went wrong?
I thought I did. I thought I knew where he went wrong.
A conviction undayirunnu. You knew something went wrong.
Yeah, I knew what was wrong, and it had also got a lot to do with the coordination between the driver and me. You know, the guy who's driving the car will have to coordinate at what point will I jump and at what speed will he come. And he'll have to manipulate his speed such that once I'm in air, then he'll have to really increase his speed and blah, 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 and all that. So I spoke to him, I took him aside, I told him what I was going to do. I told him what I was going to do and what I expect him to do, and he got the idea.
Yes.
Then I asked him to drive one so that I could see what was he doing. Then I attempted the shot and luckily I got through. So.
Anything else you would like to share about the movie that deserves a mention?
No, I mean, it's just, what I really hope for is that when you see the film, you recognize the effort that was involved. Yeah, of course, all films have big efforts behind them, but what I mean is the sheer physical effort that would have to be undertaken for a film like this. I really hope that comes through, because I don't think I've put in so much physical effort for a film like Hero.
And what do you think about the Malayali crowd in Kerala? What kind of movies actually work? Namukku family, family related stories aanengil, bangara homely stories aanengil, it actually clicks in Kerala. And you see certain movies don't. So
I actually have no clue what kind of cinema works in Kerala, because a couple of brilliant films come along and they make a mark and they do well, and you think, wow, everything is changing. And then something atrociously stupid comes across and becomes a big hit. And then you're thinking, okay, hang on, what am I supposed to do? Am I supposed to do the good thing or the bad thing? So, and then you end up doing what you believe is a good film, and that sometimes will not be, taken the way you would have hoped it would be. And then you think, okay, maybe I should go back to doing this usual run-of-the-mill formulated stuff. So it's all, it's all very indecisive. But what is really heartening to see is that over the past couple of years, there have been genuinely new original attempts being made.
Yes.
A lot of films that have taken inspiration from current society and, current...
the reality.
Yeah, what you see around you today have given birth to thoughts that have been translated into cinema.
I think it's been well accepted in... by the Malayalis,
it's beginning to be, I think we are beginning to see a shift in the way cinema is perceived in Kerala, and it's a step towards the right direction, and I hope that this is only the beginning of a journey.
So just like this movie, I think movies are also a doorway to understanding the real world now, because for example, enda veetle mammike chela karyangalokke arilla cinema undu idakke ingeneyanalle ennu choikkum. So movies nanyal, it's not just for entertainment, it's also for information, and I'm sure this movie is about ee stunt cheyna aalkare kurichu, and
I think if there is any information that Hero carries, it will be on that regard, because I think in a way it will be an eye opener for people who don't know what kind of life or what their issues are or how they perceive cinema. It's a whole, as I said, it's an area of cinema that has never gotten any publicity and probably never will.
Yes.
So in that sense, it's an eye opener for people to know what their life is about.
And tell me about the songs in the movie. Like music aanallo oru movie netum kodile promote cheyan namaku kittuna oru opportunity.
Yeah, the film has got 4 songs and the music is done by Gopi Sundar. I love his music and I really think Hero is one of his best albums.
Yes.
I like all the 4 songs personally.
I heard 2 of the melody.
Okay, the melodies.
Melodies, it's really nice. அது கேட்டா நேரா நான் உறங்கியது because I wanted to hear this song before I came to interview.
Yeah, both those songs are, both those songs are doing really well and apart from this one fantasy duet between me and Yami, all the other songs, the 3 other songs in the film are part of the screenplay.
Mm-hmm.
They actually serve as an instrument to narrate the story further. So in that sense it was very important that the music had to gel with the film and it does. And not just the songs, even the background score is quite brilliant for Hero and all credit should go to Gopi.
So that's Prithviraj talking to us about Hero, the latest movie, and I'm sure it's going to be a hit because I'm sure, fingers crossed.
Yeah, I always have my fingers crossed.